we're going to get started now that it's 4:10-ish. Thank you all so much for being here. This is the first Tech Talk of the semester. And we'll be having these events roughly every third Tuesday throughout the semester. There's a schedule up above the table where all the snacks are, and you can also find out more about it on the LITS events calendar. We're going to have a lot of different Tech Talks on different themes related to technology in teaching and learning. And we're really excited about this one because we get to introduce exciting things like digital competencies, which is a new big initiative, and also our fabulous interns from this summer. So I'm going to let Beth take it away to get started.
Okay, thank you, Valerie. Hello, I'm Beth Seltzer. I'm the Educational Technology Specialist here at Bryn Mawr. I'm going to spend about 10 minutes introducing the digital competencies. Some of you are familiar with this already, so you might hear something you've heard before. And then we're going to turn it over to our student panel so we can get their perspective. All right, so to start off, how many of you have used some sort of technology today? Just by a show of hands. All right, has anybody, did anybody communicate online with somebody? Yeah. Has anybody fixed something that went wrong in the last like month or so with technology? Quite a few, all right. So as you're doing these things, these are all ways of building your digital competencies. You have all already gained many of these skills. So the digital competencies at their core are a framework of skills that have been vetted by faculty and by alumni, including potential employers for students, about skills that would be useful for the digital age. So they fit into five main categories. Digital survival skills are all about the sort of being able to troubleshoot, fix when things go wrong. Metacognition is in there too. Digital communication is all about being able to talk and tell stories online. We have two data ones, data management and data analysis. This is all about handling the facts and data that makes up so much of our lives nowadays. And critical making design and development is about coding and building websites, but also things like project management, digital scholarship, and kind of these upper level skills. So why the digital competencies? So they're useful for students as they go through their daily lives, but the real core of why we think this initiative is important is what happens to students once they leave Bryn Mawr. So we know from research in careers that students who are able to talk about their digital skills get a leg up when they go into the working world or onto grad school. Arguably, even if you just have the word digital on your resume, it increases the odds of you getting a job if you're able to talk coherently about your digital skills. In a study of liberal arts graduates, they found that liberal arts graduates can nearly double the number of jobs they can apply to if they bring some field-specific skills, many of which are tech skills, like coding and data analysis. And for students in tech majors and STEM fields, creating a digital portfolio is also important, being able to not just kind of list off the tech that you have, but also to really weave a story about all the things you can do. So this is kind of the research behind why we think this is important. How do students build it? This is something that we know already happens a lot at Bryn Mawr. Students are building digital skills in their classes, curricularly, but also in student clubs and study abroad and work and activities and hobbies. These are things that are built all during a student's career. And part of the digital competencies intervention, as it were, is to build in times when students can focus and reflect on all that they know and start to figure out ways to present it to different audiences. So, there are 19 competencies. We don't really see this as a checklist for students to complete. It's more of a map, so different ways of engaging with this can be meaningful to different students. So for example, you might have a student who gets a lot of skills in one particular area. So this student is really focused on digital communication and developed a lot of competencies around that area. But you can also have a student like this one who dives really deeply into just a couple of areas. The student is building real strength in data security. And you can also have a student who samples really widely from the different competencies, builds a lot of different. All of these are success stories of the digital competencies. So our goals for this initiative, we have three. The first is awareness. We just want to help students learn more about their competencies, help identify what they are. We want to surface and encourage opportunities for students to build these competencies. And finally, we want to build in opportunities for students to practice articulating them to different audiences. This is one that's particularly important. We believe it's particularly important with a women's college. We know statistically women don't rank their tech skills as high as men, even if the tech skills are identical. So we're hoping that part of the purpose of this initiative is to help our students really celebrate all that they can do and really articulate it in the best possible way. So if you are a student or faculty or staff looking to get more involved in this initiative, there are a couple of ways you can do it. We have a new website recently launched, brynmawr.edu/digitalcompetencies. It's got new stories, a lot more information. It also has some upcoming events, and I wanted to give a shout out to this Data and You Intensive, which is happening this weekend. If it's something that you might be interested in, it's 2 days, open to all majors, all about gaining different data skills. There are tracks for GIS and for qualitative analysis, public health. It's really cool stuff, so that's an opportunity for you or for students to pass along. The website also has some fun, fun quiz where you can start to uncover what your own digital competencies, interests, and personality is. It also has some upcoming stories, events, and news. It can help you identify different programs that might help you build digital competencies. So, for example, this is a little spotlight on the Digital Scholarship Program, which also offers fellowships and other opportunities to learn digital skills. And I wanted to shout out one upcoming opportunity for students. We are looking to design a new t-shirt for the Digital Bryn Mawr Initiative. So you can submit by September 30th for your chance to win a Kindle Fire and your printed t-shirt to have this shared throughout the community. So there are some flyers in the back, or you can go to this link. There are various ways to turn it in. So I just wanted to give a shout out to that. All right, so now I'm going to turn it over to our students. So we have some fantastic student interns. Over the summer, we were able to pilot some of our programming with them. So they helped us develop many of our materials, our workshops. There are resources from them on our website. If you've got one of the flyers from the back, they helped us with the design and content for that too. So they're fantastic, and we're really excited to talk to them about what they did and how they used their competencies. So I'll stop there. Thank you.
So I guess I realized I didn't introduce myself earlier. My name is Melanie Bhatti. I also work in educational technology services, and I'm part of the digital competencies project team. And I'm here to sort of moderate this student panel, although I think they don't need to be moderated by someone else. I'm sure you can do that one. So why don't we start by having each of you introduce yourselves, and you can say your name, what year you are, your major, and I know when people ask me for a fun fact, it's hard to think of a fun fact. So what's your favorite in the
world? I'm Francesca Agnello. I'm a senior at Bryn Mawr. I'm an anthro major, Italian minor. I guess my main digital competency, or maybe the one that kills me most developing, is the metacognition lifelong learning competency, because I think it doesn't have to just be digital, it applies to any time you learn a skill. Valuing that time of reflection, figuring out what worked for you, what doesn't work for you when you're learning. And that also helps others if you're trying to teach someone else, you have to reflect back on how you learned something. So that's my
Hello, my name is Messi. I'm a junior data science major, and I think my favorite is project management, just because I really love to see the progress of an idea into an actual tangible object, an actual solution that helps people.
Hi, I'm Emily Sanchez. I'm a junior at Digital Competencies.
start with the most that I have in addition to spot in the same question going down the line. So why don't you tell us about one of the most memorable parts of your internship with ETS, and this can be your favorite part, something that surprised you, a big challenge, or a significant learning experience, whatever stands out.
I think the most memorable moment was going to the Digital Humanities Conference in Philadelphia, Keystone DH. That was my first conference with, you know, professionals and academics, you know, real adults in the real world. So it was a 3-day conference, so each day I forced myself to talk to someone new. And I even asked a question during a Q&A session, which I was very proud of. It gave me the confidence that, even though I don't, maybe I'm not as prepared or experienced as other people here, you know, I there's still potential, there's still a possibility. I still felt like I belonged there. I was able to fit in. So that was, I think, my favorite part of the internship.
My favorite part was actually at the end of the internship when we got these papers that had all of the competencies we had developed. I thought it was a really pleasant surprise, and it just made me see how much I had grown over the course of just 10 weeks, and it was really amazing. And I think what made it even more amazing was that I was doing things that, I mean, I was doing new things, but I was also doing things that I usually do like on a daily basis, but now these things suddenly have like significance. I thought that was amazing. Yeah.
I guess I'll go over like a surprising challenge that I had. So part of our jobs as interns was to write documentation for all the new Moodle changes that we have been using. Part of that was like writing documentation alongside and I kind of learned that I needed to communicate a bit better with them about which project I was working on, or else we would end up with like writing things that didn't need to be written, or that were already written, or just making sure that we were communicating properly to each other and to the audience that we were trying to explain the new Moodle changes to.
So you, some of you might have touched on this, but what role did the digital competencies play in your summer experience? And how did the having that language, like you described, Leslie, how did that change the way that you understood your work?
I think one of the major takeaways for me as a senior, or I was a rising senior over the summer, so I'm a real senior. the digital competencies really helped me with career development, you know, putting a name to the skills that I have. Sometimes I would even overlook, I didn't even realize it was a skill that I had that like was worth being named until, oh, it's on the sheet, or it's in a list, or oh wow, I can market this. So I was very conscious of that during the summer, which is helping me now do resume work and writing cover letters and things like that. So I tried to be very conscious of it over the summer, trying to like mark down my different skills that I've been working on. So.
I think that, like she said, presentation was one of the main things because, so I thought that when you take all the projects that we did and you break them down, you realize that it's really just like this huge ball of so many different competencies. And it just made me think that like so many of the things we do are really just that. They're usually just like a lot of simple tasks that require a little more attention and a little more like consciousness of what you're doing. And then it becomes something that's like, you know, really useful or really big. So I think that over the summer during the internship, I just realized that all our projects were not single individual things, but they were all really connected by the competencies that were written out. I think that really gave more understanding to the skills that we have. Yeah.
For me, it really taught me to keep reflecting constantly on what I was doing, because that really helped me to realize all the value of the skills that I was learning, and the skills that I already had and didn't realize had value.
So Francesca, you already touched on this, but and I guess for Emily and Leslie, since you shared the answers, it's like maybe not quite as close to you right now, but how do you see the digital competencies being useful to you moving forward? And that could be like maybe in your major or your thesis or you know, when you're looking for internships or work.
So as an anthro major, I have a research thesis. So digital data visualization and analysis will be quite important, especially if I'm going to be researching on human subjects, I'm going to be collecting a lot of data. I have to figure out how to understand the data. I'm a visual learner, so visualizations are great for me to understand things. So over the summer, I was dabbling with Tableau, which is this really cool data visualization program that makes beautiful maps and charts and things. So I'm not, proficient yet, but that'd be really cool if I could use that to help with my thesis and also help others understand my research and thesis.
So I'm a computer science major, and I think that design thinking and project management are going to be some of the key. Oh, and are going to be some of like the key things. That in fact, I'm doing them already technically, and those I can really project and see in the future there. And another thing is, I think that this has built my self-confidence as well, because now I can actually really describe what I'm saying without like stuttering or like sounding confused or So I think that self-confidence and just like the skills that I'll use in class and in the future.
So as an English major, I can definitely use digital research and scholarship to help me find all the articles I need for some sort of big English research project for my thesis. And as a intended film studies minor, I'm looking my audiovisual analysis will help me to write and produce videos that will be more coherent, I suppose. just being able to understand these skills and how I use them and to articulate it to potential employers or to on LinkedIn. That would be super useful after college.
It's really cool to hear you guys talk about the different things that you learn. I feel like it really reflects a lot of what we have seen in the digital competencies and what we hope students will get out of it. So it's really nice to hear you guys say that. Are there areas where you are all hoping to like, pursue new skills that you haven't really thought about, but that maybe you were introduced to during your internship, or things that you're starting to see that would be helpful for you? Like I know Francesca, you mentioned Tableau. How did you realize that was something you wanted to start learning about?
Well, actually, at the Keystone DH conference, someone was talking about how they used Tableau, and I had no idea what it was. They didn't really explain what it was. They were talking about, I think it was Makeover Mondays, where you get like a data set with, an okay visualization, and you're tasked with creating an even better or more interesting visualization that might tell you something different about the data. So I was interested in what he was talking about, so I looked it up. So that was fun. Right.
Are there other things that you're hoping to continue developing, or are you just focused on Tableau for sort of thesis world?
Well, over last semester, I was debating between two different classes, and one of them was a comp sci class, but I couldn't really fit into my schedule, so I was like, maybe not, maybe this is a sign or something. But then during the summer, I got really interested, and also working with Alicia last semester for the digital scholarship research assistant position, where we were coding, well, sort of, I tried. So it really, those two experiences combined sort of made me, you could change around your schedule, it'll be fine. So now I'm looking in for a computing class, just, because I think it's an important skill that I want to have.
So for me, the Keystone DH conference that we went to, most of it was all about data and cataloging and those kind of stuff. Yeah. So it actually piqued my interest because initially I was vaguely interested in data analysis, but after going to that and hearing about the different things they do with data and the mining and all of that, I thought, oh, this sounds really interesting. So now I really wanted to build skills in data management and preservation. And sometimes I just go, I actually checked out Tableau, and I thought that was really cool. And I proceeded to register for an online R course because that teaches how to use the R for data analysis and things. And I enjoyed it, so. Possibly pursue a career in that. Possibly.
Do you have a plan for your next step in exploring data?
I am looking for internships. So that helps me with that. I've been looking. I just typed data analysis internships, and I know it's gonna be hard to find some that at my level. But I'm thinking that as I can continue to just learn things online, and I'm actually taking a statistics course because of that. So I can.
We're so excited.
Sorry, this is our fault.
It's just the intro. it's a start because that it's a lot of statistics plus the platforms that you use to study the data. So.
Yeah.
How about you,
Elaine? You could talk about ideas that you have, even if you haven't actually put anything into action. You were working until relatively recently, so
yeah.
It's been like a year. You know? It's okay.
A matter of weeks.
So I've been taking more film studies courses and trying to make sure that if I have to look at that, if I see a film, potentially thinking about taking courses using Lynda, online to teach me more skills on campus, Adobe Premiere. And I guess recently with project management, that's been really useful because I've been using the workshops that we use to teach us about project management and how to give a presentation. One of my friends has said that she wants to try to hold a small convention here, so I've been trying to be a soundboard for that and offer advice on how to plan that and to contact and how to break it down. So that's been useful.
Very cool.
I hope it works.
I guess I'm wondering, this isn't as concrete of a question, but how did your experience sort of in the internship and thinking about your digital skills, how did that compare to what you expected when you first started the internship? Did you think of your skills in the same way? Did you think that the work that you were doing, that you were going to be doing, does that correspond to what you actually did, or was there a big difference from your perspective?
To be honest, I didn't know what to expect. So, I guess every day sort of, it took me about a week or so to get into the routine of a structured morning, then afternoon exploration of these different competencies and things like that. Usually I either have a very structured schedule or a very flexible schedule. So it took me a little bit to get into the routine to like feel that I'm actually accomplishing something. But once I settled in, it was good. But I didn't really expect too much.
And that there's a lot of resources available to help you get gain more skills if you realize you want to become more confident in something, or like if you want to gain this skill at all. So look for the resources there.
Thank you. So why don't we give our interns a round of applause on that? And then we can open it up to questions from anyone who's here. If you want to ask the intern something, if you'd like to ask Beth or I something.
So can you just like describe what this internship was?
Oh yeah!
I just heard ETS and 10 weeks and then...
So Educational Technology Services,
which is us.
Is ETS. Yeah.
We are officially part of LITS. Okay. Library and Information Technology. So that's the sort of structure, right? And these folks had a summer internship with us that was 10 weeks long.
We were digital curriculum interns. The name is important also. Which, actually, I think the name was a bit, because I expected to be working more with faculty, but instead we were working a lot more with like the ETS crowd and like group and stuff, which is fine.
Thank you.
Yeah. So we did a lot of documentation for tech documentation for Bionic, for Moodle, like a lot. So much new Moodle stuff. Are you guys first years? I'm going to put you on the spot.
She's a first year, I'm a sophomore.
Okay, so you've noticed that Moodle's a bit different.
Yes.
Yeah. So we were. Yeah, it does look better. Yeah. So we were, along with Helen in the back, who's like the Moodle expert. So we were tasked with trying to make the transition to like new Moodle a bit easier for students and faculty and staff. But that was one of the many things that we did. So.
I think that's it. It's just a lot of self-help materials because we also did video tutorials. We would do like screencasts for Bionic for the freshmen, those who weren't still very comfortable with it yet. And we also worked on like conference videos. So there was actually a conference. The never-ending a conference held here earlier in May, and we were like in charge of making those like very professional. I think we did a good job.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Yeah. So just like self-help materials, and also for the digital competencies, like we did a lot of research to gather like resources, and then we also did like brainstorming sessions, just to get a better structure for how the initiative would go. So those were like the main parts of our
We would attend workshops that they put on for trying out the digital competencies initiative, and we give them feedback on materials that they give us based on digital competencies. And we also filmed some videos and wrote a lot of tech documentation. It was kind of whatever projects they had for us, basically. Which is also what our jobs are like.
It was also cool because we were working in the same room as two other ETS interns who were working with the Microsoft HoloLens. They were working with Pearson, which was really cool. So they let us, we were their guinea pigs, and they were trying to like figure something out, and like they'd be like, hey, do you want to see, how this is? And so that was really cool too. So even though we weren't like directly working with them, we communicated and we like threw ideas back and forth. And we actually helped them with project managing their own projects.
Yeah.
I'm just wondering what you think the difference is, if there is a difference, between learning you know, a skill or developing a new understanding of something in an internship via versus in an academic course during the year.
For me, it's harder to, I guess, pull out these skills that I'm learning and developing in an academic course because over the summer, the internship gave me time to reflect on what I was doing. So I was able to actually put a name to what I've accomplished. Whereas during school, it's too hectic. I don't have the energy to really think about something I've already done. So it's harder for me personally to articulate my accomplishments.
I would just add that because the academic setting, the focus is not on, like, all those things are in the background, so you don't really think about them. And, like, for instance, if you're doing an assignment, you have to save it, you have to, like, you have to think about it, you have to put them all in the folder, you have to, like, you know. But the focus is all on the actual questions in the assignment. No one's thinking about, you know, like, everything else that you do to the foul or whatever.
Yeah,
so,
the what, not the how.
Yeah, the what, not the how. And I think, just like she said, it makes it difficult for me. Because I do, like I said earlier, these are things that we do every time in our classrooms and things, but it never really clicks what you're doing until you have to, like, stop and, like, step back and look at it from the outside. And most of the time, we don't have the time.
As like part of the internship, we had weekly check-ins with TS, and they would ask us, okay, what digital competencies have you learned? What digital competencies have you improved on? So just having that time to talk about it and think about it, and kind of having that knowledge that in the future we would need to talk about it, that definitely put a, like, not a pressure, but like a awareness, I guess, of the digital competencies that maybe we don't have in our classrooms when our teachers don't expect that of us.
Yeah, I first want to say thank you guys are so wonderful. Listening to you articulate what you've done and learned is totally inspiring, so thank you. I have a lot of questions, but I'll start with one which is kind of burning, which is, there aren't a ton of people in this room, and what you're sharing, I think, is really important and great to hear. And so I'm wondering, knowing the skill sets that you have in audiovisual and project management, could you be enlisted to interview one another or to be interviewed again and to help us create some video interviews where you talk about the experience and what digital competencies you gain and what it means to you in the overall context of your learning journey.
Yeah.
And my related question is, do you have other ideas about, you may have brainstormed in the internship about this, but how do we spread the word to everyone on campus, especially to students, about the opportunities to gain digital competencies?
I know that's kind of difficult potentially, but if that could be a goal of a course, I think that would be useful in giving the students a idea that this is, like, important to your education and part of your education.
And not just education, but I think because it also just is important, like I said, personal development to work on, like, your skills and, like, how you develop skills. But I think for a lot of Bryn Mawr students who don't have much time to sleep even, making it not just about improving how you are, like, in an educational setting, but also for outside Bryn Mawr and emphasizing, really, like, working with LILAC, emphasizing that these skills will help you when you leave here. Because a lot of people are very concerned about what happens outside Bryn Mawr. So I know, like, a lot of frantic seniors probably benefit from learning about this, and a lot more, like, LILAC you know, coordinated events, which I know is, I think, in the works. But like they had the Lilac End of Summer Fair last week. So we had a little table. We were trying to educate the public. And people seemed, you know, into it. They were excited. So I think maybe more of that, more of the physical presence among other career development opportunities.
Maybe more fun things. things that would, I feel like after we get out of our classrooms, my schedule is so weird. On Mondays, I literally have 3 back-to-back classes where I'm literally running from one class to another, and I come back and I'm like, oh, I'm so tired. And then I have a club meeting or something, and I go. I think that the club meetings, those are places where people get to just, unload a lot of things. So subtly introducing it to them through those things would really, I think, that would really get to. Because that's the moment when you're relaxed and you're just trying to have some fun. So if you, because it's not, the competencies are not, purely academic, right? Yeah. So if we can find a way to just, conditioning, kind of, but through fun things. Yeah. I don't know how to be honest, but
when they let their guard down.
Yeah.
Stop waiting.
Yeah, I think that's brilliant.
Yeah. I think that would go, because it's like a mentality thing, and once it gets there, it just kind of affects everything else. So yeah, I don't know how it works.
Have anything else to
know?
Another question, you kind of talked about it in a way in your responses already, but for you, how important is this kind of learning compared with the learning that you're doing in your academic work at Bryn Mawr? How do you see them as coming together, and for you sort of, where are the integrations between your liberal arts education and the digital competencies? Any connections that you see, or do they feel very different?
I think for me, it kind of balances each other, because going back, I'm a computer science major, and I do a lot of purely mathematical things, just proofs and coding. And I mean, it's all nice and good, but I've come out and people ask me, oh, can you help me with this thing on my computer? You're a computer science major, right? And I'm like, I don't know if they know how to do that. I'm a computer science major, but there's no connection between what I actually learn in class and what I actually do outside of class. And I think that the digital competencies brings that together, because I think it just kind of creates this, for me, it makes me feel more whole, because if I graduate, I'm not just someone who has this bunch of formulas and logic things, but I also have a lot of other things that I can really use, which I will use most of the time outside of work, and I'm not going to be working 24/7, so it just makes me feel more well-rounded and whole, and I think it just, they really, it's like a puzzle piece.
And to piggyback off that, I think it works really well with the liberal arts, because the whole point of going to a liberal arts college is to get, more well-rounded, jack-of-all-trades-esque education. So having an additional skill set that you can learn from a liberal arts space, it makes sense. It really works with the reason why I personally go to liberal arts.
I think for me, it makes me better at academics, I guess. It helps me build off the things I've already been doing to be an academically successful person, I guess. And just lends me more skills and tools to excel in classes.
We have time.
time maybe for one more question. Is there anyone else who would like to ask a question who didn't get a chance to already? Or anyone who did already would like to ask? If not, we can just enjoy the rest of the crackers and cheese. And feel free to mingle and chat with anyone who want to talk to more. Thanks so much for coming, everyone. We hope we'll see you next week, same time, same place, for a presentation from the Digital Scholarship Summer Fellows, talking about data visualization and using that to explore archival material, which can